Before we start talking French, because that's where that variant came from, let's talk about what do parents need to know to keep their kids safe as they go back to school?
Well, the most important thing to remember for parents is vaccinations are your number one defense that we can prepare our children to go back to school to be in those classrooms. And right now, children should get vaccinated if they have not already done so. And if they're eligible for the booster, 16 years and older, they should get that booster. And the good news is, we talked about a couple of days ago, the FDA has already approved, and we're waiting for the CDC to sign off, which should happen any minute now, so that we can give boosters to children as low as 12 years of age. And as we talked about earlier, those boosters, they increase the child's immune system. So if they contract COVID-19 with a breakthrough, they can much more effectively fight it off, and there's less of a chance that they'll become very ill and or even lose their life.
Dr. Quinn, do you see another surge happening as kids go back to school?
I mean, right now, this pandemic has been so fluid over the last couple of years, it's hard to make any reliable predictions. But what we have to do is just do everything we can to prepare our students and understand that, you know, we have to encourage our students to wear their mask. We want them to social distance when able, get those vaccinations. And just wanted to real quick echo the new policy for Jackson Public Schools right here in Jackson. If someone contracts coronavirus, then they're to stay home for 5 days and then return, but wear a mask for an additional 5 days. And basically, if someone's exposed, if they've been vaccinated appropriately, meaning they've had both of their messenger RNA vaccinations and the Johnson & Johnson, and they're not eligible for the booster yet, or if they're eligible for the booster and they've had their booster, then they don't have to go home. They can stay, but just wear a mask and then in 5 days test. So this lets you know that Jackson Public Schools understands that they're following the FDA and the CDC guidelines and really encouraging all students to get the vaccinations.
Now, as if we needed another one, tell us about this new variant that was discovered in France.
Right, right. And this is just coming in. It's the IHU variant. It hadn't yet gotten the Greek name yet because it's not yet what's called a variant of interest yet. Basically, there have been very few cases in France, but the World Health Organization is watching it very closely because it has 46 mutations on that spike protein. Now, just to remind, the spike protein is the part of the virus that latches onto cells and allows the virus to invade the cells, causing someone to get infected. And the worry or the concern is, by having all these mutations, it might be more effective, meaning that it can better latch on. And also, by it being different, then it has a better chance of evading our immune system, meaning the antibodies that we've produced from a previous infection, or if we've had the vaccinations, the spike protein might be so different it's unrecognizable, which would make it more infectious. So right now we just have to watch and just really be attentive, but just understand it's not a time to panic yet, because as I said, it's not yet a variant of interest. It's just a variant that's being watched. And at WJTV, we want to keep everybody informed so they just know what to look out for.
Okay.
Absolutely. Well, thank you, Dr. Quinn.
We'll do that. We'll keep an eye out on it. And thank you for joining us this afternoon. Appreciate you being here.
And hey, thank you for having me.
Sorry, I talked right over the top of you, Dr. Quinn. I guess I don't get a sucker my next shot.